guys, welcome back. So today I'm doing something a little bit different. Sylvester Stallone just released a video on YouTube about the making of the 30th anniversary Rocky IV recut. So he is making a director's cut of Rocky IV, which I cannot wait to see because I love the Rocky franchise. I literally just watched Rocky III the other day because I just had a need to. I love the films. I love everyone in the franchise apart from part five. Even then, I will still put it on and enjoy it, but it's just, compared to the other films, it's the worst one. It's just Tommy Gunn, he's a dick. But Sylvester has decided to kind of recut part four. I can't believe it's the 35th anniversary. Now, obviously, the Rocky films have finished, but Creed has kind of taken over the reins. So it's all about Apollo Creed's son, with Michael B. Jordan in the role. And of course, Sylvester Stallone is also involved as Rocky, basically, as the Mickey character in those films, so they're cool too. So the legacy lives on. But I'm really curious as to what Sylvester Stallone is doing with part four, like he's recutting it. So I think what he's doing, and I've read this somewhere, is he's taking all the goofy stuff out of it, like all the robot stuff. Paulie got a robot because he's filthy rich now, they got money, and Paulie got a robot, and it was like a little butler kind of a thing. It was pretty goofy and stupid. So maybe they're just going to cut all those scenes out. I don't know. But I'm assuming it's also going to be released on 4K, which would be nice. So hopefully the whole franchise will be released on 4K. That'd be awesome. Okay, so let's just dive in and have a look at the making of Sylvester's recut of Rocky IV. 3, 2, 1, go. Ivan Drago, I must break you. Dolph Lundgren, the recut. America versus Russia.
Rocky 4.
Yeah, man. Is he gonna fix Rocky 5 while he's at it?
Whoa.
Boom.
Boom. That's sick. Remastered. Recut. Rescored.
Well, everyone, I don't know if this is him with the mask on, but this is the final stages of mixing Rocky 4. It's sensational, but it's great to be back at. It's like a starship, doesn't it? But this is what it takes to mix a film. Acting is one thing, you go home, okay, you learn your lines, you go back to the set. This is where the work begins. When everyone has moved on, these guys sit here, along with myself. Of course, I did it years ago, now they're refreshing it. But this is gonna be sensational. So this is the mixing board that changes the sounds, the punches, the music, enhances everything.
Punches the music.
It up 35 years. In technology. So
35
keep
years.
See you soon.
Keep punching. So obviously they're gonna they have to remaster it in 4K. Cut, cut, snip, snip.
Good.
So we have love Rocky IV.
Good. Get them up a little slower. Good.
God, he's so young. Apollo Creed.
I buy that.
The immortal Carl Weathers.
My name is Drago.
Drago. Cut to him.
You.
Mike Pataki. He stops. He turns, Drago, and then he leaves. Okay? How cool is that? So
very interesting.
Turns when you hear Drago.
Drago.
No, you're late.
Drago.
He turns right here. Turns. Just.
Oh, it's perfect.
Getting the editing right.
There.
Stallone is a good director, too.
Drago.
Oh, I'm a big fan of him. I love Stallone. Drago. Always have.
Lose me.
Nice.
Cannot, nor will it be allowed. Let's be realistic. The Russian, he has not yet had one legitimate, professional
professional fight. The bout he had with Creed was a publicity stunt that backfired.
What you guys are really saying is you don't think I have a chance, do you?
But if it prevents another fatality, it's well worth it, of course.
Some outtakes.
Well,
he's gonna start cracking up.
Nothing to say. Now, let's go back. Ask me that question again, and I cannot be defeated. Number one.
Oh, because he directed this one too, right?
Okay. And then look at me after you say it.
Wow.
Okay. Action.
Andrew,
wow.
Yourself?
Yes.
Yes. Well.
Well. I cannot be defeated.
I've always been curious about actors who direct films at the same time, about how they actually did it. So just calling the shots from his place in front of the camera. There's so much you got
to
do.
Now I want to go back to Drago's line where...
Because you have to concentrate on your performance, but also be aware of everything that's going on around you as well. Go to the dailies, watch the playback, see how the lighting is, everything.
Yes.
Because he can't really watch
Lundgren's
performance from where he's sitting.
I cannot be defeated.
How come we never use that? You cannot be defeated.
I cannot be defeated. I wonder if he's going to insert some new scenes as well.
Have you read the papers?
Good.
Do you know what everybody says? That it's suicide! You've seen him? Do you know how strong he is?
Adrian, the heart of the franchise.
Oh my god, we're missing the piece?
Oh no.
Oh yeah.
That sucks,
so
man.
So that negative is cut out. We got to find a piece in there because I wanted to go. You can't win it. And he doesn't fight back. He just goes... Oh.
Can you get it back?
And he just breaks his heart. That's
right. I'm a fighter.
I'm sure Taya Shire
will
come back.
Do you know what everybody said?
The age?
It's suicide.
Hey.
That's hard work, man.
God, it's just so chopped up. And then she says you can't win. You can't win. And that's what's missing?
Well, I think it's...
I know we can find it somewhere.
35-year-old movie. Coming soon, folks. Oh, that soundtrack. 1985 is what I was made. 80s score, man. But the Rocky theme itself is iconic. Of course, Eye of the Tiger from Part 3.
I like this. This is new footage.
So he's got new footage, just re-editing
right here,
it, taking some shit out.
By accident, right there. That's not in the original. See, I mean, that was a real knockdown. So
it was a real
let's
knockdown.
Run that back again. I want to see that again. Just go.
So Lundgren actually knocked him down.
Right here. It's not hard, but he puts me right. Bang. Bang. There it is. Down.
Wow.
So I think that's real. Let's
clipping.
Keep that in, okay?
Keep it in. Wow. They're expanding on it. That's... Oh, I can't wait. Rocky. Punch on.
Double like this, right? Action.
Full respect for the man. I know he gets a lot of flack about his but he's acting. The man can act. But to act and direct at the same time.
I dread making
changes. He's an amazing writer.
Never cut a Paulie. doing anything in this fight.
Cut Paul.
Get up, Rock. Get up. That would be great. Let's just check that out because
you gotta put more Paulie, just not the robot.
Too much of the time.
Must be weird looking at it with after 35 years, just getting the opportunity to revisit it.
This is a morass of self-discovery, kind of like a swamp. The deeper you get into it, it becomes cinematic quicksand.
Oh wow!
And if someone doesn't pull you out, you're a goner.
Yeah, you'll
and
be
pulling you out
sucked in.
Means they cut off the money.
Oh
so
shit!
That's the rope they send down. There's no more money. Okay, you got to come out of the quicksand.
So in other words, if you weren't returning to your Samaritan, you'd be continuing.
This would be.
That's right. He's filming Samaritan right now as well.
Cause, because I would be here. And then my wife would end up divorcing me, my children would disown me. That's the problem. Directors live in a, really in an isolation tank. Once you commit to a feature, it becomes an addiction, it's all consuming. And even though you think you're present, you're not present, other than in this room or making the movie. You're not present. I think Frank Capra put it very succinctly. He said that reality started when he drove onto the back lot of Columbia or Paramount. And fantasy started unreality on the drive home. That wasn't enough. There was so much to the truth. Okay, what do you got?
He's going down! No pain! No pain!
No pain! Get up! Oh, there's pain.
Okay, cover up, Rock. Take that piece. That's a great piece. Cover up. Now I need something for the get up. So, why are we here?
It's like a jigsaw puzzle. Just needs to paste things.
How many cameras on Bert Young? Two?
Good old Bert Young. So cool. This is from the trailer. Look at the height difference. That's not reality though.
Rocky Four.
I don't think so. I mean, that's so cool. Total Rocky .com. I mean, they always kind of like portrayed Rocky as being much shorter than his opponents. Like in Rocky 3, when he's up against Mr. T, Clubber Lang, he was like, there's a pretty significant difference in height. And Dolph Lundgren's character, Ivan Drago, was also portrayed as being much, like, he's a tall guy, but I don't think he towered over him as much as he did in the movie, like in real life. But I could be wrong. Stallone could be very, very short. I don't know. I've never met the man. But I really appreciate and respect what he's doing. So he's gone back after 35 years and just recutting this film. He just got the opportunity. He was filming Samaritan at the time. So maybe with COVID, they had some time off. I don't know. They kind of mentioned it in the clip there. But he just wanted to revisit this classic. I mean, it was the most popular Rocky in the franchise. Part 4 was America versus Russia. It was very, very cool. Very cheesy, very 80s. But maybe that's what he's kind of fixing, taking the cheese out of it and making it more in tone with the previous Rockies. Like part 1 and part 2 were very much character pieces about Apollo Creed and Rocky Balboa, the underdog, the rematch. And it was just beautifully done, like 70s cinema. I just love it. So, but the tone was very, I don't know, kind of dark. Part 3, bit campy. And then part 4 was just bombastic as hell. Part 5... slipped and tripped, but then part 6, Rocky Balboa, where he was retired, an older man, but he came back for one final fight, and then, you know, the Creed franchise took over. But I love the films in their entirety. Like I said, I put part 3 on just last week just because I felt like watching it. Part 1 and part 2 are amazing, and I love part 4 as well. So I'm hoping with this recut we do get a remastered 4K version of it. That would be amazing. I mean, it makes sense. He said he's using 35 years worth of technology to remaster and re-edit this film, so hopefully it gives us something special. I'm very much looking forward to it. Anyway, guys, please discuss below. What do you expect? Are you excited? Do you love Rocky? And I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching.